the night that I saw Dancing of Harlem was when I decided I wanted to be a dancer. And guess what I saw? What do you think I saw? Firebird. I saw a black ballerina run across the stage and I went, oh, because you don't know you haven't seen one until you've seen one, right? So then there was a whole stage full of brown and beige and, you know, different toned people, which I just, you know, hadn't noticed before. And I'll never forget thinking when I saw that girl in that red tutu with that head thing, I was like, I want to be her. I want to be her, right? And I even told my mom, I said, Mom, I want to be her. Fast forward about, I don't know, 6 or 7 more years, and I get into Houston Ballet. I become a core member, become a soloist, and then my dream, my ultimate dream comes true, and I become a principal dancer. And I actually get to dance the Firebird. So the process, well, it was hard. I mean, it was one of those, like, this ballet is either going to make me or break me type ballets. And I had plantar fasciitis. So my heel hurt so badly. And all we did is the Firebird was run and jump and turn and jump. And then the second time we did it, I found it and made it my own, right? This is one of the best costumes I've ever worn. It's the shortest tutu I've ever worn, but there was a lot of tulle. I mean, it was tulle for days, but red, 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 red. And he wanted fishnets tights so you could really see the definition in the legs. Red. And then by the time it got to my calf, to my skin color, into skin color shoes. There is a legacy that goes with it. And I didn't realize it until I retired. When I saw it the last time I saw it, right? It didn't dawn on me until I saw the pictures of the people who had been Firebird. Because the first thing I knew of Maria Tall Chief Dillon was Firebird. I saw Charmaine Hunter, Wax Chate. Then I saw Misty. In that, but it's different. It's not even the same production, right? So we all did different versions of it, but it's an iconic role. But there's something about being the Firebird that takes you to a different place, technically and artistically.
I'm Misty Copeland, and I'm a principal ballerina with American Ballet Theater, the first African-American principal ballerina in American Ballet Theater's now 80-year history. So it's been quite a journey, and it's also been interesting, but not, you know, just how much Dancing of Harlem has been a part of my journey. And that Firebird in particular was kind of at the start of it all in connection to DTH and then to my own journey. I was a soloist with ABT at the time, and I was at Dancing of Harlem rehearsing when I looked on my Twitter account and saw that I'd actually been cast to perform the role. Like, that role and that performance has done so much for me and my career, and just feeling empowered that I could do so much more than I thought I was capable of. And that provoked me to write my children's book, Firebird. You know, it's not the story of the Firebird, but it's really about my journey and what it means to be a black dancer and to have mentors and role models. But I was just using that Firebird character, and that Firebird has really, I think, just brought me strength, and it's also kind of gotten me to where I am today. You know, having Barbie then reach out and want to do a Firebird Barbie, it's such an empowering character. Me. There's also, I remember these early images of Gelsie Kirkland, and she's being fitted, I think, for a headdress for Firebird, and Balanchine's there. It's like seeing that image of Gelsie and then seeing that image of Stephanie were so vastly different, but they were both different Firebirds. And so it was like, how can I embody all of these different shadings of what this creature might be? I think that she's so shaded in her character. She may just come off as like this fiery, strong person, but I think that she's empathetic and she's caring and she's strong and she has so much will and drive. And I feel like that just speaks to the black female experience. That any chance I can bring, you know, ballet and the traditions and the stories to the forefront, as well as the issues, you know, the lack of diversity and racism, like, any opportunity, I will take it.
My name is Charmaine Hunter, and I am a former principal dancer with Dance Theatre of Harlem. Everything we did was different. We had to alter it because the stories are not told for people of color, you know, or to be told from our perspective. So ours is in the, you know, we're in the Amazon. And so it's in the jungles of the Amazon, and there you will find flowers and plants that you would normally not see anywhere else. And the lighting of the ballet was just like if there are trees hovering all over, you know, you see the periodic light. It was really magical the way they did the lighting and the music, and it was all choreographed well. And that was all John Terris and Geoffrey Holder's idea. It was Geoffrey Holder's design. He did everything. He traveled with us to Japan to get all the costumes for the maidens and, you know, everything. He designed it all, sketched it, painted it, tried different designs on the body, and every single one of the tutus made specifically for our bodies. Our original Firebird was Stephanie Dabney with Donald Williams, and they were an incredible partnership. And how I came into this whole thing was because at the time I was in the Court of Ballet, not at all considering anything. No principal roles, nothing like that. It was strictly Court Ballet. And we were on another U.S. tour. That tour was about 15 weeks. We were in class that morning, right before the performance that evening. And Mr. Mitchell made an announcement and said, "Who knows Firebird? Does anybody know the Firebird?" And so we looked around like, what's going on? You know, and so I raised my hand and I said, "I know it." And right after class, I ran it with Donald, and he goes, "Okay, you'll be doing it tonight." And we did it. And I had, my body never hurt so bad, but it felt so good. You know, I remember very, very clearly, he says, "When preparation meets opportunity," and he goes, "and you were ready." Just dancing that role changed me as a person. Because I realize, you know, you don't know how much work really goes into something until you have to do the work. As far as developing the character, we were all different. He coached us all very differently on how we can approach it. Number one, because of the way our bodies are, all three of us that were dancing the role, our bodies were all different. And every single bird is different. Every single artist that has danced it is different, but the confidence has to be there. The theater is a magical place. You can transport them, and the impression that you leave at the end of that performance is gonna be a lasting one.